For a new day.
Oh, what a beautiful day!
Morning, Weebo.
Hi. Have you seen the paper this morning?
Oh, yes, I did. You know, if I could solve this whole metastable compound business, I could save the college. You know, a new energy source would be worth a fortune.
You better hurry up. The loan's due at the end of the school year.
Not to worry, Weebo. I'm very close.
May I see my schedule, please? After school, there's something I know there is. What is it?
This is your complete schedule.
See.
Unless you didn't tell me something.
What is it? There's something there. What is it?
Oh, it's something to do with white.
Oh, what is it? I know it's something important.
I knew it.
Oh, no, I'm sorry. Oh. I know it's so frustrating, isn't it? I wish I could help you. But I can't.
Haircut!
School outside of the Ivy League, name me one private college or university that isn't going to bring out the trouble. I'm all right. Name another. You don't think it's too much? No, it's elegant. And it's a wonderful idea to go with the big wedding this time. It does put the pressure on the professor to show up. If he forgets this time, that's it. Well, in his case, once is justifiable, and twice is understandable, but three times.
Good morning.
Good afternoon.
Whatever the case may be, we have a lot to talk about today, so let's get into it about today.
Thank you. Whoever gave me the stick of fruit and the dead pheasant, what did you say count as extra credit? Last time we were talking about Newton's law of gravitation. To review.
Thank you.
some momentum. May I sit here? Sarah, pleasant surprise.
Hello, Ruthie.
Martha.
Martha what?
Martha, me, Martha.
You, Martha. Me, Professor.
Yes, I know.
Well, I was just going to, you know, grade my lunch, eat a few tests, and hope for the best.
How do you hold it in?
Like everybody else, Ruthie, I just cross my legs real tight.
I was talking about your excitement.
Excitement?
The wedding.
Congratulations. The wedding! Sarah, hi. Oh, it's the wedding. Oh, I'm looking forward to it. Are you happy?
It's today.
You sure?
The wedding is today, okay?
I believe you.
6:30 at the Presbyterian Church on Beach Street. We had our rehearsal there last night.
That's right. We did. It went well?
Yes, it did.
Good.
But it doesn't count.
No.
The wedding counts. And I want you to promise me on everything between us that you'll be there, okay?
I'd rather die than disappoint you.
Well, this is going to be the very last time I try to marry you.
I imagine so.
I know that I love you, but I'm not sure that you can love me.
It's ridiculous. I love you with all my heart. With every cell, with every molecule, with every atom. I love you on the subatomic level.
Come with me tonight at 6:30.
Come for what?
That you love me.
6:30.
Good luck.
Thank you, Betty.
I knew I shouldn't have come, but... Oh, I'm very crazy about him, you see, Miss Rich. And this is the God's truth. I want him to have what he wants. Even if it means you instead of me.
No, no. You love him. Don't give him up. Hey! I'm watching something! Grab her!
Why don't you be quiet?
I'm watching TV! Download some manners!
But he ain't in love with me, Miss Rich.
Tell me about it.
Stan. That's a damn shame you shut the college down. I read about it in the paper.
It's not over yet.
Well, we're doing fine, I brought them. No such financial progress. Hey, you still working on that lighter than air fountain?
Yeah, false polymer. I don't mean to be rude, Wilson, but I think it's terrible.
You don't seem too happy to see me, though.
Come on.
Look, all the years we've known each other, studying, working together. What happened between us?
Well, I just got tired of you stealing my ideas, Wilson.
What would you have done with them? You would have misplaced them, forgotten them, lost them. There's no doubt you're the brighter of the two of us. You have a genius for science. I grant you that. It's just the science of daily life that eludes you.
I made that conversation before. Excuse me, $30.
I won't deny that I hate you for your brilliance. I'm petty and corrupt. Probably would have gone mad trying to compete with you in pure thought. But I'm not an innovator like you, Phil. I'm an adapter. And to that end, I have profited from your ideas.
Why are you here?
Now, to be honest, I'm here this weekend to steal your fiance and make her my wife.
I think you'll be sadly disappointed.
I'll see you at the wedding, then.
It's a little crooked. Yeah, there you go.
You know,
The wedding was not in my schedule.
No.
Why was that information deleted?
I don't really know.
Do you have another virus?
You know, now that you mention it, I am feeling a little feverish.
Really? Mm-hmm. You are a little hot. Say ha.
Thank you.
It's not helpful.
Oh, boy. This is not good.
Oh, sir.
Rebo?
What?
Get a broom.
That'll help.
You have a cold. You should. It's 77 degrees Kelvin. It's very cold. It's starting to scrap you. You're an elastomer. Yes. I'm the best that you can phase shift. Well, let's see. You're moldable. You're foldable. You're gullible.
Oh, right. Let's see. Oh, wait a minute. Okay. And. You're ductile.
You're elastic. Let's just see how elastic you are.
Thing to be afraid of, pal. How can anything get in your window? It's closed, okay?
Maybe it's just glad to see you.
Weebo.
Yes.
Oh, do you know what this is?
A flying rubber?
Yes, that's what it is. It's flying rubber. It's flubber!
Safe, Weebo. It's just an ordinary radioactive isotope that Weber is now removing from the lead containment unit. Very good, Weber. Now, you place the radioactive isotope carefully behind the sliding shutter. See, the sliding shutter works just like a camera that regulates the flow of gamma radiation. Instead of billions of random particles, you have a precise streamer. Now, we carefully place the sliding shutter mechanism underneath the flubber, and I'm burning up in here.
We go. Gamma radiation triggers a metastable decay in the flubber itself, which releases enormous quantities of energy, and that's what kills the flubber.
Of course.
Now, doing it this way, I believe, is a lot more scientific than dropping it or kicking it or bombarding it with light bulb photon flashes.
Absolutely.
I believe controlling the gamma radiation flux, we can control the movement of the flubber itself.
I miss this one, Weebo. I'm aware of the time, thank you. Today's the wrong. I'm getting married Friday, 6:30 p.m.
No, no, you're not.
Why not?
Because you're not getting married.
Yes, I am.
You missed the wedding. It's 6:30 in the morning.
Show your face around here after what you did to me last night.
Please let me explain.
No. There's nothing to explain. You weren't there. For the third time, you left me standing at the altar.
I'm sorry with all my heart. But please listen to me, Sarah. Please, you know me. You know how sometimes I can get really fixated on an idea.
I don't want to hear it.
Sarah, you've got to hear it. Sarah, this is the reason I didn't make it last night.
Flubber.
It's a metastable compound, Sarah. In layman's terms, if you apply a small amount of energy, it liberates an enormous quantity of energy. But the total effect is transient, Sarah. The moment you stop applying energy, it returns to a quasi-plasmoid state. Isn't that remarkable, Sarah?
It's remarkable, Philip, is that I ever fell in love with you. You broke my heart. I thought you could stay home and make some green goo.
Sarah, it's much more than that. Flubber could save this college. Let me demonstrate.
No,
just give me 1 minute, okay? The flubber is placed in my back pocket. When I exit this window, I will fall to the ground. When I hit the ground, the flubber will send me right back up, unharmed. Watch.
right back.
You are going to get my sympathy. You are wasting your time. Oh, we are finished!
Sarah. Sing your song.
Screwed up big time. I got thrown off the basketball team. I flunked chemistry. I'm on a academic probation.
How did this happen?
I'm supposed to get A's. At least that's what I was told.
The only reason I loaned this jerk my college money was so he could get straight A's and go to Harvard Business School. This isn't supposed to happen.
Well, yes, sir. We talked to that Brainerd guy, the chemistry professor. Now, either he did not understand us or he forgot. The boy knew that we were having persuasion problems, sir.
I have a science requirement, you morons!
Quiet. We'll have to get the F changed to an A.
Won't work. This guy doesn't live in the real world. He has principles.
Get something on him that we can use to force him to change the kid's grade. When a man says he has principles, what he means is he can't be bought cheap.
Adding 500 milligrams crystallized sugar to common hand cream. Stirring in slow motion. Just need one spherical test subject. Surface.
Kinetic energy test number two, controlling horizontal momentum. Commencing now.
This definitely has applications in the field of sports. Oh, yes. Fluid flubber with a convenient spray applicator. It's clogged.
You've seen enough. Plenty. All right, after pulling ball heads, break for the car.
Accelerator to a sliding shutter. If I press down in the accelerator, it releases the gamma rays, and that increases the thrust. Wow, listen to that baby chirp. Now, the steering wheel controls lateral motion.
Mm-hmm.
If you turn right,
okay,
it'll steer right.
Oh, turns right.
The wheel left, it steers left. So, it functions a lot like a normal automatic shift. Drive, park, neutral, reverse, and center.
Yes.
That easy. See, what were you doing in there?
Flirting with the alternator.
We didn't touch anything. Something's under play. We're about to make a major breakthrough.
Okay, here we go.
We're ready. Weebo?
Yes?
What do you say? We take her for a ride.
Fly me to the moon.
That's it. That's the spirit. We'll fly over to Sarah's house, park this baby on the roof. Then maybe she's going to change her tune.
You know, maybe you should just go without me.
Why?
Because I get carsick.
Come on, you're not going to blow chips.
No.
You don't have a stomach.
I have a queasy gyro.
Now get over it. This is not about cars. This is about Sarah. Get in here.
No.
No.
All right. Wow.
Up to the world.
Okay, here we go.
Look at this. Wow. Let's see what this baby will do.
Yes, it does.
What's that?
Oh, boy.
You know what this means, Weevil?
What?
I'll never have to buy tires again. See you on the radio, Weevil. See this.
Wow, is this what you call heaven?
Almost. Look at it. Over, below, and beyond.
It's beautiful.
Solitude up here. Stillness. Silence.
Uh-oh.
Silly me! Turn it off. Turn it right back on. Get in front of me,
Brainerd hovering above us.
No way?
No. busy, busy day tomorrow.
Rutland would die to have you. We'd be together with nothing but time. Sarah? Lots of time.
Listen, I'm driving up on Thursday to Rutland for the game.
I'll see you there.
Should I make dinner reservations? Since Rutland is going to lose, I'll pay.
All right. If your team wins, you can buy me dinner. If your team loses, we go up to the mountains for the weekend. Can't. Do we have a bet?
I'll think about it.
I can't lose. She's mine,
Sir Isaac.
All right. One more time. What happened?
He took a golf ball, he rubbed this cream on it, and then the golf ball took off and popped Smith in the head several times. I got hit with a bowling ball. Repeatedly.
Were you drinking?
No. Two beers at dinner. Wes had a white wine with dinner.
Right.
It's the stuff he's got, sir. It's stuff. I don't know what it is. I don't know where it comes from. But... it will give you one heck of a headache.
Ah. Oh, goodness.
I wish I could make you feel better.
So do I.
Well, maybe I'm old-fashioned, but I believe a woman should love a man for what he is and not for what she wants him to be.
Makes the sentiment we both. This is really not an area you're qualified to offer perspective on.
Well, I don't have much of a smile, but I do have a brain.
I have to deal with this alone. It's a human matter, not for computers. Good night, Weevil.
Good night, Professor. This is so embarrassing.
Here. Just had this amazing dream.
basketball?
Applying a thin layer of fluid rubber to synthetic leather surface of basketball. Application complete. Secondary flubber experiment. Control elements. Bungee cord. 3-1 elasticity ratio. 50-pound ballast. Commencing now.
Wish me luck.
Fully fix the flubber on each tack before we painted?
Excuse me, Darth Vader, but what did you say?
Did you fully fix a 15% flubber solution to each tack before Weber started painting?
Yes, and how's that different?
How long does it take to paint to wear off?
30 minutes.
It looks suspicious if the flubber started working immediately.
Isn't this cheating?
No, it's not cheating, it's equalizing. You've seen the team, they should have their own telethon. Come on, we've got to win this game. I've got to do it to prove to Sarah that flubber really works. I'm going to do it right under Wilson Croft's nose. Don't fail me.
All right, squirrels, listen up here now. Okay, Rutland may have us in height and reach, weight and power, agility, speed, and talent. They have the advantage on offense and defense. Sure, they're better coached, better trained. Their will to win is unmatched in the conference. They're undefeated in their last 108 games. But that doesn't mean we can't whip these guys, right?
What a coincidence.
You're betting against my team?
It's not your team. They threw you off. Remember that?
Come on.
Michael say anything about jumping too high. Now sit down.
Looks like a lonely weekend in the mountains for you, Croft. Some sort of adhesive buildup in the bottom of your shoes. Do you have any other alcohol? What? Excuse
me. Oh, hello there. Oh, hello. That's
Rainer. Fancy yourself. I need the bottom of your shoe.
Oh. No.
Hands not over yet. Keep your chin up and your potential energy high.
Do you know what I mean?
What?
Shut up, bud.
Get the ball. Jump. Oh, you're safe.
Well, I'm on the sensor.
Jump! Ralph, front. Out of my department. For good.
Okay.
That's a little harsh.
Jump!
One of the first ones that try to complete this astonishing comeback.
Where's your rock? Plenty of time.
Rolling has the lead with the clock winding down. These rodents have fought their little hearts out time, but it looks like the squirrels are going to throw off a couple of nuts short of a bushel. Playing people by other rangers. Here's a wide open J by hat.
Jump! Dale!
Chapman soaring into the air. Can't see it. Look at it go. Chapman with wings on his shoes. Soaring to the other end. He's over there. He rides. He's running. And no fear. I'm just looking. On an incredible bridge. Chapman. The squirrels are going nuts.
This is what is it? Within the rules for a player, they're picking the ball through the hoop. Sarah?
Rainer had something to do with this.
It's the same stuff we saw the other night over at his house.
Right.
I don't know how, but I'm absolutely certain that your team cheated.
They're just being a sore loser.
Sarah?
What kind of car does that Brainard fellow drive?
Old T-Bird? Why?
I just saw it.
So?
It was flying. You heard me. Flying.
Hey, who won?
We did.
Professor? Why the long face?
understood women. Wish I understood emotions, passions. Wish I understood any of that. If I did, I would have had to spend my entire life in a laboratory trying to figure out how the world works. I would have been out in the world trying to figure out why it works. I know I love her, Weaver. If a neuron in my limbic system is saturated with phenylethylamine, that triggers euphoria, elation, exhilaration. Truth is, Weaver, I'm not absent-minded because I'm selfish, crazy, or inconsiderate. I'm absent-minded because I'm in love with Sarah.
Professor,
that doesn't matter anymore. Because I don't get any more chances with her.
No, that's not true. There's always another chance. I mean, you never know, right?
Well, just as well that it's open.
She has to move on. I'm not right for her. But you knew that, didn't you, Weaver? You never wanted me to marry her. You were right. I wasn't right for her. You're the one for me, Weaver. Just the two of us. And Flubber makes three. Good night, Weaver.
Oh, Professor.
And this is the God's truth. I want him to have what he wants. Even if it means you instead of me. I'm sorry to wake you like this, but I can't ring the doorbell.
Is everything okay with Philip?
Oh, yeah. It's not a conventional emergency. Oh, Philip would be very angry if he knew I left. But I have to show you something. Do you have a minute? Listen.
I know I love her, Weaver. Every neuron in my limbic system is saturated with phenylethylamine. That triggers euphoria, elation, exhilaration. The truth is, Weaver, I'm not absent-minded because I'm selfish, crazy, or inconsiderate. I'm absent-minded because I'm in love with Sarah.
This will be our little secret.
Sarah! Air travel!
Yes.
Oh. We better sell this to a car company.
Oh, Philip.
Dr. Reynolds. Professor. It's a pleasure to finally meet you. I believe you know my son. He used to play basketball for Medfield. Lovely old car. Mind if I take a look under the hood?
Yes, I do. And I don't appreciate you, gentlemen, letting yourselves onto my property.
I expected something more complex. There's a lot of money in your discovery. Perhaps we could make a deal.
Any discovery I make will belong to Medfield College.
At the end of the term, there isn't going to be a Medfield College.
We'll see about that.
You could make a lot of money.
If we were interested in making money, we wouldn't have become teachers.
You think you'll be able to sell it for what you owe me by the end of the term?
We will.
I'll forget the debt right now.
No, I'm not selling.
When I leave, I take my uncle with me.
We understand.
Good luck.
Pardon me, Mr. Zeldin. Are you interested in seeing a Philip Brainerd?
Who?
He's the college professor you spoke to on the 6th. About a brand new car design.
Tell him I'm busy. Thank him for the interest. And send him a hat.
Well, he's here. He's right outside.
It's called a square. It's a Swiss.
Good night, Weber.
signal. Your audio signal. Checking. It's me, Professor Greenwood. Focus. Repo. Sort of extension cord, something so I can recharge her. I've got to download her quick. Rebo?
It's all right. It's okay. Can you hear me? It's going to be all right. It's like that time you ran into the hole when I first beat you. Look at you upstairs. Do you see?
Susan.
To do with her. What happens to the soul of a machine, Sarah?
Can you fix her?
I can make repairs. But I can never bring back the life she had. It's gone. I never knew what it was to begin with. It was some sort of glorious accident. I kept trying to recreate it and isolate it and find out what it was.
Word she was displaying on her screen at the end.
Probably a file name.
Why was she displaying it?
She was damaged. It's a download, random piece of information.
What was that word? Oh, can you remember?
Try. Came with us.
If you're watching this, I'm no longer here. I hope my demise didn't cause you any undue distress. Philip, a full and complete design of me is in this file. You didn't forget it. I never showed it to you. I've made a few changes. I've removed a few of my flaws.
Professor Brainerd. Dr. Reynolds. Good evening. Sit down. You look
weary.
Yes. Weary. You came to repay your loan?
No.
I know you didn't. I was just having a little fun.
I'm here to sell you the flubber.
You been to your house recently?
Yes.
Do I really need to buy it?
Flubber is a very quick exotic substance. It's very difficult to handle. Have you tried to do anything with it?
My man is working with it. It won't be a problem.
I can make it a lot easier for you. If you give us a 30-day extension on the loan, I'll tell you everything I know and make you a great deal of flubber.
I'll give you the 30 days, and after that, you give me 2 years. Whatever you come up with over the next 2 years is mine.
That's not fair.
Shop somewhere else, lady.
I'll do it. May I see the flubber?
Would you like to show these good people to the library? To enjoy this. Professor, I got you a little help.
Oh, the lovebirds.
Wilson, shame on you.
Welcome.
So you finally gave up teaching.
How could I pass up the opportunity to transform the energy industry? Flubber. Very interesting, Phil. Too bad it's so unstable. I was just looking over the formula. Dangerous mix.
You just have to know how to deal with it, really. It just takes a few simple questions.
Hey, hang on, Einstein.
It's time.
What's this?
It's a hand cream that acts as a separating agent.
Right.
So I can handle it.
It's okay.
Thank you. She needs to assist me. Rub it on your hands. It's a squicker.
What's it for?
I use that to lower the temperature of the tank.
Let him have it. No, no. Give it to him. No, no, no. Give it to him. Stop that and give it to him. Put it in his hand and give it to him. No, 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 no. Give the gun to him.
Oh. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Smart guy.
Look out!
much as these two people have finally consented together in holy wedlock and have witnessed the same before God and this company, I pronounce, believe it or not, that they be husband and wife together. You may now kiss the video screen.
Love you, Sarah. I'll meet you at the reception. I'm almost done. It's going to be remarkable.
Please be careful.
Don't worry. These chemicals are completely compatible. There's no chance that anything could go wrong!
Feet up in the air. There's no monsters or bad guys way up here, okay? You can look out the window.
Thank you.
When you come to me, you say you love me. When you tend to go, you make others sorry. The broken heart you brought to my life, the bitter tears of a shameful life. Why you lied to me at the day you came? And why did you give me unreal dreams of? And I can't accept your